While the media feasts on crooked lawyers and porn stars, one story slips by. According to the UN, Al-Qaeda's chief bomb maker was killed during a U.S. drone strike late last year. Ibrahim Hassan al-Assiri is his name. If this is the first you heard of this, it's because to the media, tax returns are more important than terror. A true irony. The Trump administration has been so good at killing terrorists that the media can focus that much more on hating the Trump administration. But this progress shouldn't be much comfort. What was al-Assiri known for? The marriage of technology and terror. He was the Thomas Edison of mayhem. Bombs hidden in printer cartridges and electronics that could sneak by scanners and dogs. Non-metallic suicide vests. Underwear bombs. Remember those? He didn't just design them. He also trained other designers who are still alive and ticking. Meaning al-Qaeda and ISIS are still coming for you and me. But that pales in comparison to a porn star payoff. For the longest time, we've heard about climate change, but terror change matters more. Even when terrorists fail, they evolve, even if their goal is to return us to the 7th century. Mm-hmm. That will always be the next really big headline. So we should be thankful for the intel that we get from our allies and our national security folks who remain vigilant while we call each other racist and complain about tweets. Lucky for us, these are great people who aren't distracted by thousands of hacks who give us poop and call it a scoop.
They should have gotten a raise.
You know, Dan, I like to rhyme, especially if I can include the word poop.
But, yes, can I compliment another line, though?
Oh, sure.
Still alive and ticking?
Yeah, thank you very much.
Very good line. Yes. Very
thank,
good
thank
line.
You. It is weird, though. The problem with complacency, the problem with success is complacency. And we talk about this prior to 9/11. We were talking about Chandra Levy.
Yeah.
Remember that story?
Also, Shark Week.
Shark Week, that's right.
But also, I just know of a story on September 10th, 2001, the White House communications team stayed late at the White House, so about 10 p.m., working on this big problem because the New York Times was going to have a front-page story the next day, and it was going to be a doozy, and it was going to be bad. It was going to make your whole week terrible. And it was the Dick Cheney Energy Task Force.
Right.
Anybody remember that story? It was a big scandal because he allowed somebody who had actually worked in the energy industry to brief him on energy policy. 9/11 happens the next morning, and you never talked about the Dick Cheney Energy Task Force again.
Yeah.
Because it was important. I mean, we are living in good times, and that's what happens. So, well, your point about the intel community, one of the most important things that we can ask of them is to be vigilant, but also to have wild imaginations. Imagine what is the craziest thing and the meanest and most evil thing that these terrorists would want to do to us, and that's what we have to prepare for.
Yeah, that's why Hollywood helps, because they come up with great plot lines. I remember New York Times, 9/11, that day. Do you know who their guest columnist was? Bill Ayers.
Wow.
Isn't that crazy?
Wow.
A little piece of trivia there. All right, Lawrence, you're a libertarian.
Yeah.
Do you think I have too much terror on my mind, or do you think that there can never be enough vigilance?
No, I actually believe in a strong national defense. I just believe that every government agency likes to waste and abuse their money, and I don't think the military is exempt from that. One thing I will say about the president, part of the reason why we don't hear about the military so much, even though he has to, you know, so much respect for our generals, is that he said he didn't want to talk about his military strategy.
Yeah, that's true.
And he made that one of his things. Even time members of the press ask about the military, he'll tell them, no, I'm not going to talk about that. He's had great success in it. And part of it is because before he got into office, President Obama really didn't listen to the generals.
No.
Except
when they were on shows.
Exactly.
And the rules of engagement.
And the rules of engagement. Yeah. And so I think this president is going to leave. This is one of the issues that people are going to remember him for, is having a strong military.
Yeah. But it only takes one thing, Juan.
Yep.
It takes one. Only one. The terrorists only have to be good once.
By the way.
Yes.
as we do this mission accomplished segment.
Yes. I'm saying mission.
That wasn't the point.
I'm saying mission unaccomplished.
Oh, no. But yeah. Wait a second. I thought you were the one. Every day you say to me, hey, look at all these great things Trump has done.
Yes.
And I believe your number one is defeated ISIS.
Yes.
Oh, but then when I read the newspapers, I see they say ISIS.
I say decimated.
Is back.
That's one tenth.
The inspector general, 28,000 in Syria and Iraq.
Yes, it's true.
Right? And the Pentagon says they're well positioned and growing. And I think, but gee, Greg said that they've been defeated by
I said they were decimated. There's a difference.
To speak to everyone's point here, too, you guys are absolutely right. And this is part of why we have a tactic going on there and a strategy that's working, mm-hmm. which is the fact that the president pushed the decision-making capabilities in the hands of the tactical and strategic commanders. And that's why now, for example, in Afghanistan, the strategy is surgical airstrikes and counterintelligence. And it's working, and there's ebbs and flows, and some weeks are better than others. And after 17 years, obviously, it's a bit exhausting. But members of the military refer to it as mowing the lawn over there. And they basically say it's our constant presence and our efforts against it's counter-terrorism efforts there, but we're supporting the Afghan government that we helped instate and to maintain the chaos between Al-Qaeda, ISIS, the Taliban, and the Afghan government. But the bottom line is, from what we have and what we inherited, we absolutely are in the best position possible, even in the face of good and bad weeks, and it's because of pushing that autonomy to the commanders who can actually make the decision thoughtfully.
Thank you, Obama. Thank you. And thank you,
Deep State.
Thank you, Deep State, National
Thank you, Ronald Reagan.
That's able to find, because remember,
Let's go way back.
Weren't you going after Obama for using drones to attack people?
No, I've always been pro-drone.
Pro-dromal. Sending intelligence in, and we do it in a way that is specific
exactly.
and targeted.
Exactly.
And we have been having success, and thank goodness we got this guy. Because he makes it impossible for me to get through security.
That was after the August 2017 campaign. So this thing that you just cited, that was after President Trump took over. And that was his surge. I mean, granted, the surge occurred under President Obama, but this was a targeted campaign, that was the guy that was
killed. I'm saying that, but the strategy was basically Obama's strategy.
It's always Obama's
strategy. Our allies are helping us as well, don't forget. The UN announces. But I would also say, President Trump just announced today that he's canceling the 2.1% annual raise for federal employees.
Yeah.
That includes those intel people that you're talking about that do all that work for us.
Lawrence, respond to that as a libertarian.
Don't you dare.
All of them need to be cut.
Nope.
They need to live like America.
I disagree.
No.
Well, I don't know. We'll see.
But the president could say, look how much better the economy is under my leadership.
Yeah.
Look at all this tax revenue coming into the Treasury. I will give this
people.
Raise because Obama starved you of these raises. And that's why federal employees, you should love me.
That's why.
Even
blame
if you
Obama.
Don't, that's
what?
Fine.
So blame
that's
Obama. Don't blame
Trump. But here it is.
We give a tax cut to the richest people in America.
But we
refuse to pay federal workers, including those who killed this man. How absurd.
They also have better health care than us.
Oh, yeah. Stop.